Okay, you've made it past the first round. Not too shabby. I'm sure Mr. Vitale will agree there's still plenty of games left to play, and one of them is this second round game between the TCU Horned Frogs and the Arizona Wildcats. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Wildcats are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Hey, on a night like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, reward your big man. Give him the ball down low. Get him into the game. Let him be part of the offense. Second of all, make sure you eat up the boards. And finally, keep it simple defensively and play as a unit.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action. See what's in store for us. And in and out. He'll regroup the offense. Quinn handles the pass. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. Time to pick up the defense here now. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Kicked out from down low. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
He goes to the line for the first time. First shot, good. Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBN.
Gave it up, looking for a screen on top and got it.
That was awesome, baby.
He goes to the line for the first time. He sinks it. Oh, screener took some punishment setting that pick. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. Nick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Way off target. Nat is animated and ready to go.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Inside, and now there's a whistle and a foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, that's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Intercepted.
Dump it inside.
Fed the low block. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
On the dribble, gives it up. He was looking for the call, and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats him to the spot.
On the outside, the power forward handles the feed. Quinn makes a great move to draw the foul. He steps up to the line. He buries it.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say?
And he missed. He keeps the dribble as they reset. Defense! Defense! Defense!
strip, Brad.
Pushes it up. The ball goes out of play. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Goes up for two.
The land. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Got to take some pride on the defensive end.
The point guard receives the ball, puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. And he scores despite the hack. Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He got busted for three.
He was watching, not playing.
Points off turnovers, Dick. A stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify. Great shot block right there. And some good movement on the offensive side.
Inside. He shoots from left of the circle. He nails the shot. He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
If you get the steal, you're a hero. But you always run the risk of committing a foul when you go for that steal.
High post flashes for the ball handler. Grace receives the pass. He attempts the three, way off target. They work the perimeter. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
They work it around the perimeter.
There's the screen up on top.
I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
Trying to pack it inside for two. Can't get the shot to drop. And the ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Time, the Horned Frogs are up by four. Best play of that half. Let's take another look. Arizona carelessly gave away a lot of possessions by turning the ball over.
Their coaching staff must be livid right now. The amount of extra opportunities they're giving away is just absurd.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. He intercepts it. Gave it up. Moving it around the perimeter. With a deep shot from outside. Drains it. Both teams are looking to get something going here. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Now looking to move it down court in a hurry. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
The shooting guard with the ball. He unloads.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Defense! turnaround jumper. He can't get the hoop to fall.
Not getting enough motion of offense in here on transition, Brad.
Working it around the perimeter. Way out on top. Controlling the ball.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the outside. Cross court. He tries the three. TCU have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad. Dump it inside.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Looking for a good shot. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job by the defense, not allowing.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
Thanks, Aaron. Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the skiers change somewhat.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He puts up the tray. He hits the shot. The point guard gets the ball.
Up and inside.
The shooting guard gets the pass. Number 54 with the foul. First team foul. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby. Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
The center takes the feed. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
They work it around the perimeter. The power forward takes the pass. Number 43 with the fake. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And the ball goes out of bounds. Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. And look at that stat.
I tell you one thing. Coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose the air and you get balled like I am.
Shot clock is dead. Goes up for two. They still don't score. They work the perimeter. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Horned Frogs graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.